Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for joining us tonight. Now, please welcome to the Millennium stage, Eunbi Kim.
Thank you. Hello. Hi, thank you so much for coming to tonight's performance. My name is Eunbi Kim, and this program, Read Last Night, was inspired by an email subject that I accidentally looked at when I was on the subway. And when I saw this, I started imagining what had happened with this person who got this email read last night, and imagined all kinds of scenarios, romantic scenarios, funny scenarios, scary. And I started thinking about what night means to me. And I think of night as this really magical in-between space where you can be alone, and there's so much of the unknown that occurs during this really beautiful time. So the first three pieces I just played for you, I think, represents one aspect, which is, I think, you know, passion and desire. And the next two pieces offer a very different side.
Thank you.
Do you guys like that? It's very different, piano with toy piano. Before I play the next piece, I just wanted to set it up a little bit. It's you'll be hearing a world premiere of a piece that composer Daniel Bernard Roumain wrote for me. And he's a composer that I've been wanting to work with for a while. We had a great opportunity to do it through the Korean consulate. And he wanted to have an electronic element to this piece. So when I told him about this program, about how I wanted to explore different ways of thinking about night and different experiences we have at night, he wanted to come to my apartment and record sounds from outside my window at night. And I live in New York City, which is generally loud, but my building is really quiet and my apartment is really quiet. So what we ended up doing was he interviewed me and asked me some really personal questions about just beautiful memories and painful memories and things I hadn't thought about in a really long time. And he took this conversation and edited to be played along with the piano part that he wrote. And what I discovered in this process with him is that, in his compositions, he delves a lot into exploring the self, and he explores his various aspects of his identity in his compositions. And through this, I realized a huge part of my identity is being a daughter and being my parents' daughter, and how much that has shaped who I am as a person and also as an artist. And I'm grateful to DBR for writing this piece that really honors my parents and who they are to me.
I'm afraid that
it's so strange because I only speak Korean to my parents.
I'm afraid of being away from my loved ones.
Family to
Sung Kim, Yeon Kim, Diana.
First person to get.
And my mom was a. My dad was one of his jobs.
And then she's never talked to her brother since.
I don't know why he did that, but he did come to my first birthday and. She got very upset, so she told him to leave. I don't think my father even knows. He just knows that because
and he's the one who told me a few years ago, and my mom has never talked about it.
My first birthday party pictures, she doesn't look very happy, and I think it's because we would celebrate Christmas and I would
but
get Christmas
gifts.
But
it's just amazing that
so
they
that
put together
the next day at school I could say I have got this and that.
Make all these
and,
things happen that I really...
The other kids got really like
piano lessons,
very
dance lessons,
big
and
birthday parties, so they would save a lot of...
They would save money
throughout the year so that I would get... I would have a big birthday party.
Got it.
They didn't do anything for themselves, so I had a really happy childhood.
I would like
not want to have...
Well, my father, he's been...
I guess...
And, Seonglin. He really encouraged Korean and English creative things. It's so strange because I only speak Korean to my parents. Mani 사랑했어. Fabric paint. 하고, he didn't spank me growing up or anything like that. And spanking and that's kind of normal for Korean people, actually.
없으면서,
and I didn't grow up like that. And my dad and I were so close.
One thing that was really beautiful.
He was such a gentle person. So
your grandparents
really broke my heart that he did that.
Really much.
Didn't have much money.
They gave me everything they had, even though
they really didn't have. They sent me to a school with a lot of really privileged kids,
and they worked extremely hard to give me a good life.
And I was maybe the one of. I was the only. Asian person in my grade for the first 6 years of my school. Six or seven years.
Yesterday, I was talking to my mother because I told her that I missed her chicken soup, and I was telling her that I really can't get this soup here, and I can't order it or anything like that, and I don't know how to make it, and only she can make it, and then I just... I cried a little bit, but maybe I was just kind of hormonal or something, because I normally do not cry about the chicken soups and stuff.
Okay. My mom's sleeping already. Should I keep talking to my dad? Okay.
told them recently that I would like to transition first because I don't wanna live in this life without them. And mom said that that would be incredibly painful if I died and she was still living, because it's unnatural to bury your child. And so I don't want to really but between the two of them, I don't know, because I feel like they're both like really healthy and they do all this stuff. I mean, I'm pretty sure there's a very good chance they'll survive me, actually, because my dad and my mom are, like, complete health nuts. My dad always sang Yesterday by the Beatles. I thought he had written it. He's, like, a big Beatles dude. And then, sang all the Beatles songs, actually. His favorite one, and then he sang Hey Jude a lot, and so I knew this since I was really little. Oh yeah, he went to the library and then he made a bunch of copies and told me I should told me to play them.
And you played them?
I did, yeah, when I was a kid.
You played them now?
Much, and they worked extremely hard to give me a good life.
Before we get to the last piece, I just wanted to thank some people. I wanted to thank Dinah Ezrins for giving me the opportunity to perform here for you tonight. I'd like to thank all the tech and the crew for being so amazing and putting everything together. And I'd like to thank everybody, my family and my friends, for coming here tonight. There wouldn't be a concert without an audience. So thank you for supporting the arts. And I just have so many fond memories growing up and coming to see so many amazing performances. So it means a lot that I can be here and perform for you tonight. So thank you.